Beach Nuts here with David Wolf live. We are here at the Loggerhead Marine Life Center in Juneau Beach. This is a sea turtle hospital. And we are here with Hannah Dedman, and she is going to tell us a little bit about some of the things they do here at the hospital.
Hi everyone, welcome back to Loggerhead Marine Life Center. If you haven't seen before, we are a nonprofit sea turtle hospital located in Juneau Beach, Florida. That's located in Palm Beach County, and we are adjacent to one of the world's most densely populated nesting beaches for sea turtles. We can have anywhere between 12,000 and over 16,000 nests just on 9.5 miles of beach. That's monitored by our research biologists every year during nesting season from March 1st through October 31st. And they're out there on the beach counting nests, marking nests, documenting the beach profile. So they're looking at the shape of the beach and beach erosion, seeing the impacts that both natural and human factors can have on endangered and threatened sea turtles. So right now you're looking at Dr. Paul. This is a loggerhead, sub-adult loggerhead sea turtle that was found accidentally hooked near the Juneau Beach Pier, which is actually managed by Loggerhead Marine Life Center. So our hospital team was able to go over and rescue the turtle. Blood work showed that the turtle was hypoglycemic and anemic. But of course, here at the Sea Turtle Hospital at Loggerhead Marine Life Center, we work to ensure that these turtles are assisted medically. We treat them with a variety of innovative medical procedures and treatments so that these turtles are able to be rehabilitated and released back into the wild. So we're not a zoo, we're not an aquarium. We are a fully equipped sea turtle hospital. The only one actually between Orlando and the Florida Keys. So we're working really hard to save our endangered and threatened sea turtles. Another interesting point to note is that sea turtles tell us the health of the oceans, and the oceans tell us the health of the planet. So although we have a focus on sea turtles, we're really looking at sea turtles as a great ocean ambassador. Whatever we're seeing going on with sea turtles is a good indicator of what's going on with other species in our oceans, like fish, marine mammals, even seabirds that inhabit the coastal areas and more. As part of our portfolio at Loggerhead Marine Life Center, we additionally have over 35 public and educational programs that teach folks from all over all of the work that we do here at the center, from our Junior Vet Lab, which is a hands-on interactive program for the little ones, all the way up to our Science for Seniors lecture series and our winter seminar series. We are here to educate the public about the importance of ocean conservation and the steps that everyone can take to ensure that these animals are protected.
Do you have any idea on his anticipated release date, Hannah?
Well, Dr. Paul actually came to us in April. So although it's different for each sea turtle patient how long they stay temporarily at the center, sometimes we don't exactly know their release date until a couple of weeks out. But the good news is that Dr. Paul is progressing well and should be able to return to the ocean healthy and ready to get back out there and continue carrying the species on. Yeah. Dr. Paul is a loggerhead sea turtle, and loggerheads, they are carnivores. They enjoy hard-bodied animals like mollusks, other crustaceans, crabs, lobster, all kinds of those guys. So they have very thick and powerful jaws to be able to bite through those animals. You can't really see it with Dr. Paul, but some of the loggerhead sea turtles that come into our center that are chronic debilitated, think of that like the flu for sea turtles. They have a very sunken in neck. They're very underweight and lethargic. So we give them antibiotics, fluids, and other medications so that they're able to receive nutrients and be able to eventually eat on their own.
And how many patients can you accommodate at one time here at the center?
Well, we have a little bit over 15 tanks here. So at about, if we were at full capacity, we may be at about 17 to 18 patients. Most of the time we are at full capacity, so we do speak with other rehabilitation centers in the state of Florida, so that if there is a stranded call, we're able to still help the turtle and ensure that somewhere that turtle is able to be cared for if we don't have the room. And other turtle rehabilitation centers are able to do the same thing. They're able to ask around, they go through FWC, as do we, to ensure that the turtle is going to the right place and is rehabilitated.
Have you ever had a return visitor?
We have seen some of our former patients be in the intercoastal because we equip every sea turtle with a flipper tag. So that enables us to see, if we do happen to come across it again, where it is. Some sea turtles are outfitted with a GPS, obviously satellite tracker, and that enables our research team and our rehabilitation team to track where that turtle is moving. Sea turtles don't know borders, so they can travel hundreds and thousands of miles through our oceans. So we're able to see where they go. As long as that tracker still transmits, we can track their movement. And you, too, the public can track the sea turtle as well. If you go to marinelife.org, that's our website, you can track some of our sea turtles that have been outfitted with a GPS tracker. And it's a great way to follow and see where they're going.
How exact are you able to determine their age?
We determine the age of a sea turtle by their length. So there are different categories. So we have our hatchlings, of course, those are the sea turtle babies that you see sometimes on the beach during nesting season. We have them here at our center at times during nesting season that are rehabilitating. And then there are post-hatchlings, that's the next size up, followed by juvenile, then subadult, and then full adult.
And where would this guy fit in on that spectrum here?
Dr. Paul is a subadult loggerhead. And what's interesting is that loggerheads don't reach full maturity until about 25 to 30 years. So when you hear the statistic that only 1 in 1,000 hatchlings will survive to full adulthood, we're talking 25 to 30, maybe 35 years, depending on the species. So it's really important that we take care of our oceans and remember the simple steps that everybody can take, like bringing a reusable water bottle with you wherever you go instead of the single-use plastic bottle, taking a reusable bag, trying to reduce printing things on paper, all kinds of things that we can all do to reduce our impact on our environment and our oceans as a whole.
And what would you say is your average number of releases per year?
Well, we rehabilitate on average about 100. In 2016, we released about 15 to 20 of them, over 20 actually. So some of them are only here for a couple of days if they have a very minor injury or even just were found floating and then they were examined and determined that they could be cleared for release. We do not release any sea turtles until they are medically cleared. That means we're giving them the best chance of survival that they could possibly have. Some of those factors that include indicators to show us that they're ready to be released include a healthy weight, of course being able to eat on their own, blood levels are average and normal, and other factors.
Who do we have here?
So this is Gaston. Gaston is also a loggerhead sea turtle that was found just north of here, our center, emaciated and in need to be evaluated just before the turtle could be classified as chronic debilitated. So again, chronic debilitation, that's like the flu for sea turtles, occurs when the turtle becomes lethargic. It's kind of like getting sick. You don't want to do much. So they're slow. They often have barnacles and other epibiota on their shells. We call that carapace. And they need to receive the proper medications to be able to get better. Thankfully, though, Gaston is improving, and we are monitoring the blood work and the appetite of the turtle. Thank you. we have, as I mentioned earlier, three species of sea turtles that nest on our local beaches. That includes loggerheads, like Gaston, leatherbacks, the largest sea turtle species that can eat their weight in jellyfish every single day. And they weigh up to 1,500 to 2,000 pounds sometimes. As well as green sea turtles. Those are our resident vegetarian sea turtles. They need healthy seagrass. And they feed on that, munch on that along the reef system. There are two other species that enjoy our local waters but don't nest on our beaches. And that's the hawksbill sea turtle. They feed on sea sponges on the reefs. And then our Kemp's Ridley sea turtles.
I understand you also offer nighttime sea turtle walks.